amigos, una nueva edición aquí de Auto 060 en Cristina Radio Network. Tenemos un show con mucha información, muchas entrevistas. Estuvimos en el Homestead Speedway, en el final de la NASCAR, donde hablamos con Juan Pablo Montoya. También tenemos entrevistas sobre la tecnología diésel. Tenemos una entrevista muy interesante sobre una nueva iniciativa para elevar el límite de velocidad en el estado de la Florida a 75 millas por hora y las consecuencias que esto puede traer. Así que vamos a empezar un poco con este tema de seguridad, y vamos a hablar con Kristen Nevels. We're going to switch back to English to talk to Kristen Nevels from the Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety to talk about this initiative to put the limit of the speed limit in Florida to 75 miles an hour and the consequences that it might have. Here we go.
Hi, Kristen. How are you? From the IIHS, Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety. How are you?
Good. How are you, Javier?
Excellent. So, very interesting initiative about increasing the speed limit in Florida to 75 miles per hour. I mean, to be honest, most people are doing that already, no?
Yes. A lot of states are increasing their speed limits, unfortunately, because what we see, what happens, basically, almost a third of all fatality crashes here in the United States are a result of speed. So that's about 10,000 crash deaths a year result from vehicles that are speeding. And the bottom line is that raising the speed limit increases the number of deaths on the roads.
Yeah, but in those cases that you were mentioning, the speed is the only factor, or is one of that? Usually every accident has more than one factor, right? But is this the main factor then?
Right, it's the main factor.
Yeah. And so this urban legend, I guess, is that when you're like on the road and speed limit is 65, if you go about 5 or 10, it's pretty much the same. I'm going with the flow, they call it. But, I mean, it's illegal, right? I mean, 1 mile over the limit is illegal. So increasing even more will create more accidents, is the institute is saying?
That's correct. Basically, like you said, even whenever the speed limit, just say, is at 55, most people go faster than whatever the speed limit is, 5 or 10 miles faster. So just consider, if you're going 65 and a 55, if you're raising the speed limit up to a 75, as what's being proposed in Florida, then people will be driving 85 miles an hour on a regular basis.
Yeah. Is there any consideration, or is it too early to know about the advantages of the new technologies? I mean, some cars pretty much drive themselves, almost, like when, like, intelligent cruise control and all those things, cars that brake themselves, keep lane keep assisting systems. Is there any consideration into that with the proposed speed limit?
Well, what we're studying, we've studied a couple of different types of crash avoidance technologies. Mainly, our latest set of ratings that have come out have been on forward collision warnings.
Yeah.
And what we're testing a lot of times is at lower speeds. So we haven't done any high-speed testing on those systems. So we, at least for us, the research isn't out there to show how they work in very high-speed crashes. The highest speed that we got to in our crashes was 25 miles an hour, and there are some systems that are working very well at that speed, but we haven't had anything that has really gone over that 25 mile an hour speed limit.
Yeah,
speed.
And usually your testing is pretty serious, and it takes a long time, and not only to do it, but then to analyze the data. And again, this technology is pretty new, right?
Correct, yes, for most vehicles. There's, like I said, there's a ton, well, as you mentioned, there's tons of different types of technology, and one of the main things that we're studying here at the IIHS is the forward collision warning systems.
Yeah. So do you have any information also, I believe in Texas there are at least one road that is it's a toll road that the speed limit is even higher than that, than 75, it's 85, I believe. Is that
right?
And I think that opened like a year or 2 years ago, the most. Do you have any
last
information
year
about any accidents, increase of accidents there while the speed limit was increased there?
We don't have any specific data on what's happened in Texas. Our data is just kind of widespread across the country what happens when speed limits go up. So, no, we don't have anything specific to the Texas speed limit increase.
Yeah. Going into other areas of the work the Institute does, again, we're talking with Kristen Navel from the Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety. You've been testing a lot of new cars, right? And speaking about safety, a lot of new cars are getting your top rating for safety.
Right. The Institute last year introduced a more difficult test. It's called the small overlap test. And traditionally, our tests were about 40% of the vehicle hitting a barrier at 40 miles an hour. This new test only hits 25% of the vehicle hits a barrier at 40 miles an hour. And the latest vehicles to get that top rating are the Volvo XC90 and the Subaru Impreza, and it also has a crossover twin that's the Subaru XV Crosstrek. So both of those tests performed well in that small overlap, and what we look for in a vehicle that performs well in that test is that when the vehicle hits the barrier, the driver space is maintained, which means like that crush zone at the front of the car, it doesn't crush, it crushes enough to protect the driver, the airbags deploy. Both of these vehicles have side curtain airbags that also deployed. So they were able to get that top safety rating.
Yeah, so the common thing in these two vehicles and all the cars that have surpassed this new testing is basically airbags and the structure of the car?
Yes, it has a what we call is the occupant compartment, of course, is where the driver and the passengers of the vehicle sit. So that occupant compartment is very strong, so whenever it sustains a crash, it's able to hold up.
Yeah. You mentioned the Subaru XV Crosstrek, the original version with the gas engine. They just announced, I mean, I was last week testing the hybrid version of it. Is that one has been tested, or would the test will apply to that one too?
We have not tested the hybrid version, so I cannot speak to the rating on that one.
Oh, okay. So basically, and this is a general question about this specific vehicle, but when there's a hybrid version of a car that has an original gas engine, the testing result changes because of the weight of the car, or there's just like different elements to it?
I think it's a couple of different elements involved. So generally, we try to test both hybrids and the hybrid electric engine and the regular gas engine.
So they're different. Okay. Well, thank you very much, Kristen Nevels from the Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety. And again, can you please share again the website where our audience can look for more information about the Institute?
Sure. It's the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety, and we're online at www.iihs.org.
Okay. Thank you very much, Kristen.
Thank you. Have a good day.
Bye. You too.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.